Good morning and welcome back to my channel. Thank you very much for tuning in. Firstly, wasn't planning on recording anything today, however I have just checked in, just had feedback from Vicky, and today is a refeed. I have been running this meal plan for about 7 days 10 days, I don't really know at this point, a relatively long time, and I've dropped body weight consistently every single day. I've dropped about nearly 5 pounds in a week. It's quite a lot. So today's a refeed. What I'm gonna do is jump on the bike now. Cardio when you know you're having a refeed is always fine, just because you know there's a big bowl of cream of rice coming at you at the other end. And then I will just show you what I'm having for my refeed today. Again, no crazy different new food sources. Cream of rice, more rice, rice cakes are the only extra things I'm having, but I am incredibly happy to be seeing 80 grams of cream of rice on my plan and 50 grams of my breakfast. So yeah, today is gonna be a good day. I should feel nice and full. I will take you through the refeed today.
Here we have the first meal of today's refeed. Normal breakfast, just with a little bit less egg whites, most likely because we're pulling protein down ever so slightly today to account for the extra carbohydrates. The main event, I'm so excited. I haven't had carbohydrates in my first meal for like 8 weeks. So I have 50 grams of cream of rice and 50 grams of blueberries, which I'm so excited to eat. And then, of course, normal coffee, normal sups.
That is meal number one in. I feel so nice and full. It's lovely. I'm just actually about to head out and grab some more bits and pieces for the refeed today. I need some more berries, rice cakes, and a few other things, which I've completely forgotten. But that's fine, that's standard. I'm probably just gonna do 2,000 or 3,000 steps, just because I'm not used to having this much food in me by this time, and my stomach and digestive system isn't the best. So I just wanna kind of get things moving and make sure I don't run into any issues later in the day. So I'll be having my pre-workout meal next. I'm training about 2 hours earlier today. So yeah.
Just noticed this Ben & Jerry's. Can anyone tell me if that's any good? Mm, 100% predictable. The pre-workout meal for today's refeed is 80 grams of cream of rice, which is literally double what I normally have, 100 grams of strawberries as normal, and 30 grams of whey. Off to really train pool. I'm very excited for this session. I have stiff legs, just the one set of stiff legs, and then the rest of my pool session as normal. So yeah, I'll catch you guys at the gym. With no words on it. I got on 2 chains. No, I ain't boy. I'm dream chasing, but I ain't fulfilling, boy. Yeah. And she say I can get it, boy. This is it, and I'ma make it. I'm feeling, boy. My soda range, my sweater saying in my campaign on 10. I'd like to be deep better, but I'm really into her friend. House off in the hill, got it off a cool. Aventador, Lamborghini, condo off a Biscayne. Dumb in my lane. Fresh as hell, no stain. Robert Jean with the stone. Deception match my chain. I'm different, I was built for them. My don't rock Tiffany, and you a rat. You'll sing a symphony, and I'm back. Street been missing me in my white silly. My car ignorant, I'm the king of my city. I'm banned up and I ain't in the band, but my flow just like an instrument. Bass, grit that. Yellow tape on the trees that. Hating is a disease. What they do that?
Oh man, your bitch, your bitch, bad, she getting fast, ain't no romance. My diamond dancing in 3D, like a fake strip when you see me. Your money wrong and my money long, and I'm playing with it like P.E. Real no joke, don't think it no hope. I got a minute and a wanna carve it up under my coat. And I don't want you, plain gas, only thing I saw. And I gotta thank God for the drinkers on bank here. Shout out, they tell me everything I know. Like, how do to your partner, let him it through the city. Really? We bout that action. You try, and we turn to the mat. That's a motherfucker. I'm a real E-Rap. Aye, aye.
Doors up, doors down. When I'm in the club.
Pool session all wrapped up before I go home and have my main post-workout meal. Part of my post-workout is 3 rice cakes, so I'm gonna eat those now, and then it takes me about 20 minutes to walk back to the flat, and then I'll have the rest of my food then. But very good session. I did get some bits, but sometimes you just want to train, especially when you're feeling good. I am now home and having the second part of my post-workout. So I have 65 grams of raw weight rice, 130 grams cooked chicken, 20 grams of honey. Yes, my honey is with my chicken and rice. And then another 100 grams of blueberries. Just come to realize that I never signed off my refeed day. The rest of that day I didn't actually have any extra carbohydrates, so I was just running protein fat meals for the rest of that day. But what I wanted to do in this episode was just briefly kind of talk about the actual criteria of the show that I'll be doing. I think it's something that a lot of people kind of miss out or maybe don't consider as much as they should potentially. So what I actually did was go onto the UKDFBA website and have a really thorough read through the criteria for bikini. But there was 3 kind of main points that I wanted to pick out and that are very, very important, and I know it's what the judges are looking for. If you don't look at that criteria and know what the judges want, how can you bring a good package? First kind of point in the bikini criteria, trained and athletic. This to me basically says you should look like you train. It doesn't mean huge amounts of development. So this is something that you have to consider, and you have to consider your own muscularity. If you are a very developed individual, you have a lot of muscle, then maybe just kind of consider whether the bikini class is right for you. Now, I'm gonna pop up this morning's pictures. Today is 10 days out for me, just here. From today, that is the first point. The second point, and it kind of leads on very well from that first point, the individual does not have detail, separation, and vascularity. Now, obviously, this doesn't mean that at some points during your prep, you're not gonna be separated potentially and vascular. It means that on stage, they're not looking for veins everywhere and, you know, separation through the quads. Now, arguably, I'll pop a picture here. At the UKDFBA finals in 2019, I did have quite a lot of separation through my quads, which, to be honest, I probably shouldn't have, and potentially is the reason why I didn't place higher at the finals. So they are not looking for the separation, the definition, and the vascularity that you may get within one of the figure classes. And I think it's really important that I remember that, because I know that I can get lean, get the condition where my quads are separated, but that's not what they actually want. So I think it was really refreshing for me to go back to the UKDFBA website and, you know, actually pinpoint what it is that they're after. The third and probably most important point was for an even balance of development. What does that mean? That basically means they don't want one body part or several body parts to be totally and utterly more well developed than another part. So say, for example, having a back or glutes that are like completely out of proportion to the rest of the body. And you know, there's no balance there. Now, a good example of where there is less balance is the wellness class. Now,
There is a massive kind of dominance of the lower body within the wellness class. However, with bikini, with UKDFBA bikini, they want the development to be balanced overall. So you're not going to be top heavy, you're not going to be bottom heavy. Where I think I've really improved is I think I am a lot more balanced this year. In 2019, my lower body was very behind my upper body. It lacked development, it lacked density in the glutes, the hamstrings and the quads. So this year, to be bringing some legs, which I'm very, very proud of, to me, that's actually bringing more balance to my overall physique. The only other thing that the criteria really mentioned, that there is an aesthetic overall shape. That just simply means that the flow from your head to your toe of your physique is aesthetic. A lot of this can be defined and exaggerated through your posing. If you cannot make the shapes where your physique looks balanced and aesthetic, then that's gonna take away from your ability to look aesthetic. This is why posing is so important. They don't just set you mandatory poses for no reason. They set them so they can look at the balance from top to bottom of your physique. So I thought I would just go through that and explain what am I actually being judged on. I realized that I spent a lot of time on here talking about training and nutrition, but when it comes down to it, on show day, what are the judges actually looking for? So that is the criteria. Each category does have their criteria. So I would say if you are looking to compete, it's very important that you know, you understand what the criteria is, because that's how you're being judged, right? You don't want to come off stage, be unhappy with your placing, and then read the criteria and be like, oh, actually, I didn't hit any of these criteria points for that class. So yeah, I just thought that would be really insightful for people that aren't familiar with the UKDFBA. Today is a rest day. I do tend to pick up the camera more on a rest day for several reasons, but one being my energy. I have a few more bits to do. I'm currently wearing my fluffy pajama bottoms because I'm really cold. It's also 22 degrees here, but prep, and we are 10 days out. So I hope you enjoyed that kind of explanation of, you know, what it is that I'm being judged on.